Hello, my name is James Richards, and I'll be presenting today for Accounting 6650, Accounting Ethics Seminar, taught by Dr. Christensen at Southern Utah University. I'll be presenting today on my research paper on moral courage. As an outline for today's presentation, I will begin by exploring my thesis and introduction to my paper, after which I'll move to the proponents of the thesis, followed by opposition to the thesis, and finally, I will offer a conclusion. As an introduction, the thesis that I have chosen is moral courage is necessary to succeed in business. To gain a more understanding of moral courage and some of the various components of this thesis, I have provided several definitions. One definition of moral courage is the will to choose what is right. Another, more expanded definition is the fortitude to convert moral intentions into actions, despite pressures from either inside or outside of the organization to do otherwise. An even further expanded definition of moral courage is a commitment to moral principles, an awareness of the danger involved in supporting these principles, and a willing endurance of that danger. I think that final definition is a great one, encompassing many aspects of how challenging it can be to demonstrate and exemplify moral courage. Also, I'd like to offer a definition of success pertinent to my thesis. There are many different types of success in business, personal success, financial success, but ultimately, to really be successful, in my opinion, this definition and thesis must encompass all aspects of success. Success for everyone involved in the organization in every degree possible. That is a more holistic definition of success. So we could restate the thesis with a little expanded information to be stated that regardless of opposition and pressures, a commitment to moral principles is mandatory for personal, entity, and financial success. I think that's a little more understanding into my thesis and topic today. Now I'll move to the proponents to this thesis. Again, the thesis is moral courage is necessary to succeed in business. There are two key supporting arguments. First is moral courage, and second is ethics education. Moral courage is very important in business today. There are several elements of fraud and dishonesty that plague the business world and have for decades. Moral courage is the solution to problems in business, and that's really what my paper is founded upon. Also, a supporting argument to the thesis is ethics education, as previously mentioned. The basic ethics education is very important. We all have a basic moral foundation, but ethics education is necessary to expose us to specific circumstances that we will face in business and the business world. There are two key components why ethics education is necessary. The first is to gain confidence, to act upon those, to act morally courageous. Also, the second component of why ethics education is necessary is because it teaches the valuing moral courage. If people valued moral courage more today, there wouldn't be the instances of fraud that plague the business world and are so prevalent in the media today. The next aspect is opposition to the thesis. Again, the thesis is moral courage is necessary to succeed in business. Supporting arguments of that opposition is the definition of success, an incorrect moral foundation, and career and financial losses. First, definition of success. Again, as mentioned, success could be interpreted by some to be much more basic, to simply be that personal or financial success. However, we've talked about this previously and have refuted this argument. The next is the incorrect moral foundation. Just because you call an orange an apple doesn't make it an apple. If someone has incorrect moral foundation and principles, then it doesn't mean that if they act morally courageous upon those incorrect principles, it doesn't mean those actions are right. Again, emphasizing the importance of how we have to have correct moral principles and then act courageously upon those. The third opposition to the thesis could be career and financial loss. You risk losing your job, your reputation, and even career by standing up for unethical behavior. Opponents to the thesis would say that If you lose your job for acting ethically and opposing unethical behavior, you're worse off than if you had acted unethically. You can't provide for your needs and the needs of your family. Finally, the conclusion. Again, the thesis of moral courage is necessary to succeed in business. The restated thesis is, regardless of opposition and pressures, a commitment to moral principles is mandatory for personal, entity, and financial success. To me, it boils down to doing what is right and wrong. There is a way to know what is right and what is wrong, and I'm proud to declare that. There are universal truths that everyone throughout the world can understand, and there are many natural consequences that testify of those simple, basic truths. If we would all act upon those basic truths, there would be no problems, or very little problems, in business today. Thank you very much.